Christ who calls us. Amen.
Amen.
Oh, I'm short again. I can still see you. I love this reading for a July day when our gardens are beginning to sprout and look hopeful. My tomatoes have gone from being just little things like this to, you know, things about like this, and they're setting up some little buds on them, and I'm getting ready to think that we might have tomatoes before September. Who knows? And then I stroll out of my garden and look around in the alley, and there my neighbor's garden is. Of course, he puts his out where, you know, the sun beats down on it all day long. His tomatoes? Can you tell I have tomato envy? And what's the difference between his and mine? The soil. I stuck mine in the ground with a little mulchy stuff. My neighbor, he builds a concrete bed, so of course it's warming all the time, above ground, with, you know, it fills it with Miracle-Gro. And he has these ginormous macho tomatoes, and I have these little wimpy ones. What makes the difference is the soil. When we put our plants in the ground, they were about the same size, and we did it about the same time. But he put a lot of effort into cultivating his soil, building up a wall, and paying the big bucks. Those are going to be expensive tomatoes, I'll tell you. Matthew is telling us a similar story. He's telling us of God's insane generosity. The word, the good news, the gospel, the love of God, God's presence, the kingdom, however you want to talk about it. The sower goes out just spreading it everywhere, willy-nilly. We do nothing to merit that seed. It is just cast out. It's kind of crazy. Seems like bad stewardship, perhaps, on the surface. But God is generous that way. God is generous that way. The gift of the good news is available to absolutely everybody. The difference between the places where the seed takes root and grows and thrives and doesn't is the soil. And the bad news is we are responsible for our soil. We need to show up. We need to receive the seed. We need to prepare the ground. If our hearts are stony, if they are dry, if they are closed, if, having prepared the soil, we ignore the weeds, nothing grows. Or it grows and fails and does not bear fruit. So how do we go about preparing our soil? God is generous with the seed, with the gift, with the miracle of growth, but we are responsible for our soil. And what do we do to prepare it? At first blush, one might think that this has to do with enormous effort, like being morally virtuous or something. Now, I don't think being virtuous is a bad thing, but I don't think that is what Jesus is shooting for here either. Paul gives us a clue about all of this in this very complicated but gorgeous piece. Paul talks about setting our mind on the flesh or on the spirit. And interestingly enough for Paul, setting on the mind on the flesh does not merely mean being preoccupied with self in a negative way. When Paul talks about the flesh, he's not, first of all, talking about the body per se. Elsewhere in Paul's writings, he talks about all of creation, all of physical creation being good and declaring the glory of God. So please do not hear Paul as condemning our bodies as in and of themselves evil. But the flesh system, if you will, is that system that orbits self. And certainly we can see how that works out in negative ways in terms of morality. When people are self-absorbed, they don't treat each other as well as they might. But sometimes when people are self-absorbed, they're very good. They are absorbed with avoiding guilt or pleasing somebody, maybe God, or maybe being better than other people. It's still all about me, however, in that system. And Paul says you need to break out of that system. That system is over. That system by which we feel we need to chalk up enough brownie points to get into heaven, have an advantage over somebody else, where it's a competition of some sort. He says, that's not the way the gospel works. You don't strive to get into God's loving grace. It's a gift. Yet, we have to set our mind on that gift. We have to set our mind on the Spirit. The mind set on the Spirit, says Paul, is life and peace. So I'm thinking that this soil preparation has to do with where we place our attention. Not so much about Herculean efforts to be good or better, waking up tomorrow and saying, I will not, whatever your particular vice of the week is. But instead, waking up in the morning and saying hello to God. Waking up in the morning and unfolding your heart before the Spirit. Waking up in the morning and opening your eyes to grace. Practicing focus and attention on God's loving presence in our lives cultivates the soil so that the seed can indeed penetrate and be nourished and thrive and grow. This is the kingdom of God. It's not sometime in the future. It is here. It is now. It is not far away above the clouds. It is in our very hearts and in our very lives. And what is required is our attention. Whether that is in prayer and meditation, whether that is in walking in these doors with the intention to open your heart and receive the gift that is being offered in the Eucharist and in the Word, whether that is in praying the daily office, whatever it is, those moments of intention and connectedness loosen up that soil and make room for the gift. And do not forget, the miracle is not the soil. Well, maybe if you buy Miracle-Gro, but the miracle is the seed. The soil, the water, the sunshine, that's all straight ahead. But who would think that this little itty-bitty thing would turn into this great green leafy plant with beautiful little yellow blossoms that turn into gorgeous red tomatoes? That's crazy. It is nonsensical. The abundance and the miracle of that tomato is beyond description. That's what God is planting in you. That is what God is growing and cultivating in you. And that is not the result of you being extra good or extra virtuous or being on God's good side. It is a gift, free, and generously given. And all we need to do is turn our hearts with gratitude and attention to that gift. Make our hearts available to the grace of God, and it will grow within us, yielding peace and life. Amen.
Amen.